Hi guys, I have a very special video. This year I'm going to be doing a holiday advent calendar. So every single day I'm going to make a new video. I might skip a day or two in between because I'll upload more videos on the weekends usually. And also, I'm going to be doing it until New Year's. Hi guys, today I have a Batman Series 1 Dorbs. It says Vinyl Sugar underneath, and this is number 35 from DC Comics. And this is Killer Croc. And these are the other ones. And for Guardians of the Galaxy, I actually got almost the whole entire set. I have like 6 Dorbs of them. So be sure to watch out that epic video coming soon. And subscribe if you want to see more videos of Funko and Dorbs. And I have a bunch of Batman Mystery Minis that I'm going to be opening soon too. So be sure to check that video out. Here is an example of one of the blind boxes I'm going to open. And these are all really cool, so be sure to subscribe. Anyway, here he is. And you can move his head all the way. This is him up close. Turn it around. It's basically the same thing. And he looks a little bit like the Chaser from the Science Fiction Mystery Mini Funko series. The Chaser, 1 out of 72, was Facehugger Kane, and I got it. This kind of reminds me of him, and I'll put the link to that video so you can watch it after you finish watching this one. And anyway, thanks for watching, and be sure to check out my Funko and Dorbs and Mystery Minis playlist to see more videos like this. And be sure to subscribe so you get notified when I make the Guardians of the Galaxy Epic Dorbs video. And thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below. Hi guys, today I have this universal clip lens, and I just wanted to see if it worked or not. So you can use a lens to have a fisheye, macro, or wide-angle lens, which can create pretty cool pictures. So I don't know if this will work or not. And I'll test it out. So here it is. Trying to focus. You have this little bag over here. You have the actual lens that you clip on. And then this is the macro lens. And this is the case for this lens, which is the fisheye lens. And the wide-angle lens should be here somewhere. So I'm not sure where the wide-angle lens are, but for now here is the macro lens. And I'll clip it onto my camera and show it. So this is the box right here, and it looks pretty cool. So this is what it looks with the lens, and now I'm gonna try to remove it on camera. So here's the lens, and this is how it looks without the lens. It won't focus right now. And then I'll put the lens back on. This is how it looks. So this is the wide angle, and I guess it's a fisheye, and now I'll try putting it on. So this is what happens, and it will not focus because of the lens. So this is what's gonna happen if I remove it, and this is what I do it, what happens when I put it on. So basically, the only thing that actually works is the wide eye lens. So I put the fisheye slash wide lens back on, and it's kind of sad that they only make one lens for both because it's supposed to be separate. It's a 3-in-1 photo lens, it says over here, but it shows like fisheye, macro, and wide angle. And they're supposed to be different things, not the same. And the only thing that works is this one, that's the fisheye slash wide angle one, I guess. So, anyways, this is basically it, and I'll show this once again since it's the only thing that works. So, it's like this. And then it's like this, which is pretty cool. But besides for that, it's not that good. So the one lens that they gave is pretty cool, but the other one that doesn't work is obviously not cool because it doesn't work. And this is the bag they give to put your lens in. And it looks like a pretty cheap bag. But anyways, it's okay. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below.
next.
Hi guys, today I have the Nerf Firestrike Elite Gun. This is an end strike gun from Nerf. So I usually open the box and show it on camera, but today I wanted to make a quick video, so I already opened it and everything. So basically what you do for this is you load in the darts. You can only put one at a time over here, and there are two that you could put over here for storage. So you pull it back like this, and then you just press to shoot. And the button on the bottom you click for a light, like that. And I'll show it like this too. Shoot it up.
This makes like a beach ball light.
Hi guys, I have the Hello Senryu Happy Meal toy number 3. This is My Melody Music Shop. And since I got requests to, I opened some of the Happy Meal toys of this set before and I showed them on McPlay. So you could see Happy Meal toys of Hello Kitty or Hello Senryu on McPlay by clicking the link. And this just says to download McPlay and unlock a game by scanning your toy. My Melody. You get some stickers over here. And you can use them to decorate this on the inside. And then you put her in that little hole and then she stays there. So this looks pretty cool, and it's like a double Happy Meal toy because you actually get like two toys in one. You get one of this or one of this. So this is pretty cool. And anyway, here she is. And then there's a little hole here. You could just put her leg on it. Could turn her around, make her face the window. And then she'll stay there. That looks pretty cool. Anyway, here's the toy up close. Hi guys, I have the Game of Thrones Mystery Minis, Edition 3. And usually it says Series 3, but this says Edition 3. And by the way, this is from Funko. So I'll just get the packaging off and then show the box. So these are the figures that you can get, and there is a 1 in 12 chance of each. And they all look pretty cool. But this is not my favorite Mystery Mini series. There are definitely ones that I like a lot better. Like the Harry Potter one may be my favorite. So I can't really guess who it feels like because they're all like humans, but in some of them, they're like different creatures, so you could kind of guess who you get. And after this video, be sure to check out my other blind box videos. I opened like 20 blind boxes already, at least. Oh, this guy is pretty cool. And he was actually one of the people I wanted the most. Imperfection on his head, but you can't see it.
Be sure to watch my other Funko Mystery Mini videos. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below.
Hi guys, today I have two Pokemon TCG Steam Siege card packs. And these are both Volcanion packs, and these are actually fake, but they have really cool cards inside, so I will show them. And I opened two whole booster boxes of these, so be sure to check that video out. And each pack is supposed to contain 10 cards, but they actually only include 9, which is kind of sad, but the cards are still pretty cool. And usually one of these packs, all of these packs have at least one EX in them. Some actually have three. So those are the best packs. So we have a Kling, Ponyard, Volcarona, and I really like these cards that this is like half grass and half fire, and they look kind of cool. Pyroar, Iavital, Greedy Dice, Lugia EX. And these are some of the bad cards in the packs. Like, the colors are not that good, and this doesn't look that cool because of the colors. But from the back, it looks pretty real. And I also have more Lugia EXs from my real packs, and they look a lot cooler than this. And the rare holo card, the one that they show like this in the back, is the rare holo card. So the rare holo card is a Heatmore. So usually these cards aren't that good, but in my last video, I got a really cool one, and you have to check that out. Let's hope that this is one of those 3 EX packs, because those are pretty cool. They usually have like a break card and then 2 EXs. Nidorino, Flaffy, Apom, Jirachi EX. And this card has nice colors if you compare it to this. And then a rare card is a Zygarde. So these aren't the best cards in the pack, but I like the Jirachi EX because the color is nice. I don't really like this Lugia EX because it looks like really fake. And then we have this Heatmore and Zygarde. And they look okay. But I got cooler cards in my last video, so if you want to see that, then click on the link in the description below, and thanks for watching! Hi guys, today I have 2 Pokemon TCG Steam Siege Ivetal packs. And these are actually fake packs, but I'm opening them because they have really cool cards. And I have 2 whole booster boxes of these. So be sure to check those videos out if you want to see me open more of these. And the saddest thing I've noticed about these is that it says 10 additional game cards, but you actually only get 9. And when I did the booster box video, I was just like looking at the cards and I did not even notice. Well, anyways, let's get this first pack opened up. So the first card they always give you backwards, I don't know why. And that's usually the holo. We have an Apom, Monferno, a Jirachi EX, that's pretty cool. And then the rare is a Milotic, and this looks really nice even though it's fake. In some of the other ones, the quality was a little dull and they didn't look that good, but these two are pretty cool cards. Oh no, it fell. There we go. And now let's open up the second pack. And if you like Pokemon Go, you could check out Pokemon Go gameplay videos on Time for Tekken Games. And I have a link to that in the description below, so you could check that out. After this, and you can also check out my other Pokemon videos in the Pokemon videos playlist. I just saw an EX. We have Ninja Boy Raikou EX. That's really sad. There's a Pikachu and it says Raikou EX on the top. If it said Pikachu, this card would be pretty cool because the picture is really nice, but no, it has to be a Raikou. And then the rare holo card is a Articuno, Team Mystic. And I revealed my team in the video where I opened the booster box and 8 of these packs. So if you want to check that out, then click on the link in the description below. But these are pretty cool pulls for just 2 packs. We have Articuno. I also got Zapdos in one of the other packs. Actually a few. But that was an EX version. And I also got an Articuno EX in one of my Pokemon videos. Then we have this, which is kind of sad, so let's move it to the back. And then we have a Milotic, which looks really nice. And a Jirachi EX, and these colors look pretty fine. And from the back, they look like real Pokemon cards, even though they are fake. Like, some of the cards in here, you could tell that they're fake. For example, this one, you could tell from the borders that they're like slightly off. But the backs are fine for these, which is kind of cool. But I'll have to put them separately so I don't mix them up with my real cards. Anyways, thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below. Thanks for watching. Hi guys, today I have two fake Pokemon TCG Steam Siege Exerneas packs. And I got two whole booster boxes of fake Pokemon cards. And they were both Steam Siege. And I tried to get two different ones, but the seller just sent me both of the same ones. But anyways, these are one of the pack cards. There's Exerneas, Iavital, Gardevoir, and Volcanion. And if you want to see the full booster box opening, be sure to check out my channel. I might upload it in parts, or I might just upload one video. And I'm just going to open two packs today. So I don't know if you could get a Mega Charizard in this or not, but that's probably one of my favorite Pokemon cards. And some of you might say that it might not be in Steam Siege, but in these cards, they're all mixed up, so you could basically get any card. And this is usually the special card, so I'll add it to the back. And I didn't have that many packs repeat yet. I already opened like 10 booster packs. And these are just like the common cards, so I'll just skip them. And this is pretty cool. It's a Pikachu, but it says Raikou EX. Like, if it said Pikachu, it would be a pretty cool card since it looks nice. However, it says Raikou EX, which is pretty sad. And then the special card is a Pangoro. And I don't really love these holos because they're like, the color is slightly dim, if you could tell. However, they are okay. Time for our second pack. Hopefully we could pull a real EX. Like, with the actual name on it instead of just another Pokemon's name. Oh, this looks like an amazing pack. We have a Nuzleaf, a Ivetal Break, a Diwot Energy, a Zapdos EX. Comment down below if your team Instinct. And I revealed my team in Pokemon Go in another video. It was actually the video in which I opened 8 of these packs, so be sure to check that out. A really cool Volcanion card. And then our final card is a Rayquaza EX. And this was the best pack yet. We got 2 EXs and a break. And then we also got a Volcanion, which is not like that rare, but still it's pretty cool since it's one of the pack arts. So this was a really nice pack, and I really like this Rayquaza EX. It looks pretty cool, even though it is fake. But the back looks pretty real. It looks like it's a real card. It doesn't look fake at all from the back. Anyway, so this is what we have so far. And if you want to see Pokemon Go gameplay videos, be sure to check out Time for Tekken Games, and I have a link in the description below for it. And let me just show you the cards we got in these two packs. Ivetal Break, a Rayquaza EX, and I have a Mega Rayquaza EX, like the real version, because I opened that box, and you could check that out by using my Pokemon videos playlist. Zapdos EX. If you want to know my Pokemon Go team, check out the video where I opened 8 booster packs in the whole booster box. A Raikou EX, Pangoro, and a Volcanion. And anyway, thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below. Hi guys, today I have a very special video. I have 2 Pokemon TCG Steam Siege booster boxes. And these are actually fake booster boxes, but I saw a lot of people got these and got extremely cool cards. So I'm really excited to open this. So it comes in just like one... It's just wrapped in bubble wrap once. Like that's basically all that's protecting it. And I expected the box to be slightly bigger, but it's not. But that's fine. So this is the front of the box. And I opened a booster pack of this Pokemon. And then there's another Pokemon there. Evolution of Oshawott. I think it's Samurott. And then some more Pokemon. Hoopa. Oh, it's actually a little bit ripped over here. Let me just get this off. And I have 2 of them. So I don't know if I'm gonna open the whole entire thing on YouTube or not. I'll probably open one box and then I'll see. So just put this in the back. Looks pretty cool. So this is what we have now. And let me just count how many packs there are real quick, and then I'll resume the video. So there are a total of 36 packs, and these are the 4 pack arts. We have a Gardevoir, and I opened this real pack. And then I'm not sure who this Pokemon is, so please leave a comment down below if you know. And I also opened another pack of this. A real version. And I'm not sure, but that looks like Exernius. And that's Volcanion. And they're only 4 pack arts, and they're 36 packs. So they're like 9 of each. And all the packs, they're not all like frontwards. Like some of these are backwards. And like the Gardevoir one was actually like this. Which is kind of sad. Like, I know these are cheap because they're fake, but it should at least be the right way. And the quality looks pretty bad on the pack arts, and I hope the cards are good. So I'll start by opening only these four, just to see like if I get the same cards per pack art, or if they're different in each pack like they should be. And in my real pack, I didn't get some great cards. But that was also a 3-pack, so there's not a great chance of getting good cards. So one card is backwards, which is weird. Nice, it's a holo Raikou EX. But the color is slightly like dim. You have Skiploom, Shiftry, Spiritomb, Samurott, Energy, a Flareon EX, Fletchling, and Klefki. So this is pretty cool, but like it looks really fake. And like some cards they're fake, but they at least look cool. Like you could see from the corners and all. And even the regular EX, like Pokemon cards, aren't this dull in color. Next up, I have this pack. And this is Steam Siege, but I'm not sure if these cards are all from Steam Siege. Like, I don't think Raikou EX is in Steam Siege, but I'm not sure. So, this is a backwards card, and it's not an EX, it's Barbaracold. And then we have the cards here. Armor, Fossil, Shieldon, Giratina EX, and this looks pretty bad. Jumpluff, Chimchar, Progunk, Fungus, Klinklang, and Dino. Now it's time for the Volcanion pack. And I've never gotten a break card in any Pokemon pack, which is really weird that I never got it because I opened so many packs. Even in fake packs, I never got a break. And they're pretty common in fake packs too. And I'll just move this one to the back. This looks pretty cool. Lugia EX, and once again, this does not look nice. If it was holo, maybe it looked better. And this is just Exernius, but it's not an EX or anything. On to the next pack. And this was actually in the box backwards. And let me just compare it to Exernius. It does look like a golden version of Exernius, but if you think I'm wrong, comment down below and tell me who you think it is. Or if you think I'm right, just tell me that. So we'll move that to the back again, and this came backwards. Spiritomb, Samurott, Energy, another Flareon EX. I'm just skipping these cards because they're like the common cards. And then this card is a Ferrothorn. So I only opened 4 packs so far, and this is what I got. Already got a Lugia, a Giratina, a Raikou, and Flareon. The Flareon colors look fine, and the Raikou is okay. And the Giratina and Lugia are pretty bad. I was expecting them to be like this, like holo. And I was expecting the colors to be slightly brighter, because this looks like pure fake. The back doesn't look that bad. But anyways, I'll open a few more packs. Time for pack number 5. And so far, no packs were repetitive, which is a good sign. Latios EX, Volcarona, and I really like these cards that are like half red and half blue in this one, because they look pretty cool. Half grass type, half fire type, Volcarona. These are just regular cards. Pack number 6. I see an EX at the back. Mankey, Hoppip, Nuzleaf, My first break card. Unfortunately, it's fake, but still pretty cool. A Yevital break. There's a Latios over there. And this looks pretty cool. Like, I expected all these cards to be hollow like this. This Articuno is a card for Team Mystic, and I got this in another video, so be sure to check that out after this one. Yeah, they also have Pokemon Go gameplay videos on Track and Tech and Play, so be sure to check those out. Yeah, this card is pretty cool. Here is pack number 7. Open his packs, like I'm gonna open 8 packs, and then I'll just open 3 more, and then I'll just show you what happens individually. I see another EX at the back. Toxicroak. Giratina EX, and this is Chinchino. So this is not a great pack. Open my last pack, and it's gonna be a Gardevoir, the first and last pack of the video. And then off camera, I'll open some more packs, and then I'll just show you what I got. I'm hoping for some nice cards in this, since it's gonna be the last pack I'm showing you on this video. A Flareon EX and another Flareon EX, and that's the Yevital break again. And anyways, thanks for watching this video, and I will open more packs if you want me to, so leave a comment down below if you want me to open more of these packs. And anyway, check out my Pokemon videos playlist with all of my Pokemon videos, and thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below. Hi guys, today I have Skylanders Giant. I have Lightcore Hex, and this toy is for ages 6 and up. And Lightcore Hex lights up. Skylander Giants bring the Skylanders to life. You could play anytime, anywhere. And the Lightcore ones have Lightcore power and a Flash Bomb effect. And this is Hex. And there are more than 45 Skylanders to collect. So here is Lightcore Hex. I took the card out. I don't want to rip it. So it's really shiny. And you could see a rainbow, which looks really cool. That's actually from the light. If I turn the light off, you won't be able to see it. So it's Lightcore Hex. So it has Skylanders Giants on the back. And then there's a sticker. And there's a code so you could play this on your phone or your iPad or Android or any device you have. Here's the code for anyone that wants it. And whoever sees it first and uses it will get it. And I also opened an igniter in another unboxing video. And I think I gave the code in that video as well. As well as my Pokemon card opening videos. In my Dollar Tree haul video, I opened like 2 packs of Pokemon. I think they had codes. And this shows that you could go on the Skylanders app and enter the secret code. So you could get the character in the game. And that's basically what it shows with warnings in different languages. So let's take Hex out. So this is Lightcore Hex. And she looks pretty cool. So when you put her on the portal, her dress lights up. It would have been cooler if the skull lit up too, but it doesn't. And she is one of the dead people. I think that's what it's called in the game. Here's a close-up of her. So right now I just unboxed her and then I'm gonna play her in the game and then show that video to you guys and put a link to the epic Skylanders video when I make it. And thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, and comment below. Hi guys, here are the Marvel Guardians of the Galaxy Dorbs, number 18. This is Yondu. And I don't know if I'm saying his name right or not, because I've never watched this movie, and I'm actually planning on watching it this weekend. Or maybe even today. So, anyways, this is number 18. This is just the back. And this is the side that shows Yondu. So here are all the other ones you could collect, and I have numbers 18 to 23. So be sure to check the description for all of the other ones that I could collect. And I have. And then you have this little seal over here. There's Yondu. And he's one of the coolest people in the set. I'll show him up close as well. Anyways, thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below. Hi guys, here are the Guardians of the Galaxy Dorbs, and this is Ronan. This is also number 19 of the set, and I have number 19, 18, 20, 21, 22, and 23. And I have a mega video in which I open all of them, so be sure to check the link in the description for that one once I make it. And anyway, here's is Ronan. Let's open him up. There's a little piece of tape here. Usually there's like a round sticker or a round piece of tape instead of just one rectangular piece of tape. So maybe this is used. And they sent me a used one instead of a new one. Anyways, here's the figure. You can turn his head. And this is the bottom. And if you want to see my other Funko or Dorbs videos, be sure to click on the link in the description once again. And I also have a Funko and Mystery Mini blind bags playlist. And I have so many videos of blind boxes and blind bags. You have to watch it. Anyways, I'll show the figure up close now. Hi guys, here are the Guardians of the Galaxy Dorbs number 20. This is Nebula, and she is one of the coolest ones in the set. And I actually have all the Guardians of the Galaxy Dorbs numbers 18 to 23, and I have a mega video in which you could check them out. And I'll put a link to that And I'll show you a picture of that video right now. Hi guys, today I have the Dorbs Guardians of the Galaxy figure number 21, and this is the collector. And I just have a green screen on the bottom because I got this to make some cool stop motion videos. And so far, it didn't work that well, but like I made the videos without the green screen, so you can check those stop motion videos out on my channel. And these are the other figures, number 13 to 24. And I have figures number 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, and I think 23. And I'm also going to be opening those up as well. So stay tuned for those videos. Put these on a display or something. And anyways, here is their figure. This looks cool over here. It's a little bit metallic. And his head does not turn, which is kind of surprising. And anyway, this is basically just the figure. And thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below. Hi guys, today I have the Guardians of the Galaxy Dorb number 22. And this Dorbs is actually one of my favorite. It's Unmasked Star-Lord. And it's one of my favorite ones from the Guardians of the Galaxy set. And I actually have numbers 18 to 23. So I'm also going to unbox these on my channel, so be sure to check that video out. And I'll combine all these videos and add some extra footage to make one video in total if you just want to watch that one. And anyways, here's the back of the box. And this is the side that just says Star-Lord. And on the bottom over here, I have a green screen. And if you like this better than just having a white piece of whatever on the bottom as the background, then leave a comment down below, or even if you dislike it. Head does turn, and in the previous video I opened the collector and his head didn't turn. Either that, or it was glued and it dried up or whatever, and it was really hard to turn, and maybe it would take a few more turns for me to make him turn. Anyway, this is basically basically it for this video, and thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below, and be sure to check the other videos out in which I open all of the other figures. Hi guys, here are the Marvel Guardians of the Galaxy Durbs figure number 23. This is correct. And I didn't watch the movie yet, so I don't know if I'm saying it right. And I actually buy the movie already, but I never get time to watch it. And this is the side, and it shows him. This is just the back. And this is also the other side, and I have figures numbers 18 to 23, this is number 23, and I also opened all of them, so be sure to subscribe so you can get notified when I post new videos, and if you don't want to get notified, you can just turn notifications off, and then you can just get, like, on YouTube, you can check your subscriptions and just see if I have any new videos of these. Anyways, I'll open this up. Pack from GameStop a little while ago, and they actually, it looked like they sent me a used one even though it was supposed to be new. And anyway, here's the figure. I'll show it up close. You can see a little bit of blood on his shirt. And this looks pretty cool. Maybe even cooler than some of the other Dwarves figures. And anyway, thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below. And be sure to check out my other Dwarves and Funko videos. Hi guys, I have 4 different Pokemon TCG Steam Siege fake packs. And I got 2 whole booster boxes of fake packs because I saw that they have really cool cards even though they're fake. And in the best packs, you could get 3 EXs in one pack. And in the worst, you only get 1 that's not good quality. And these are supposed to have 10 additional game cards, but I noticed they only have 9. Anyways, let me open them up now. So first up over here we have Gardevoir. And this is pretty cool, and I also opened a real Gardevoir pack from Steam Siege, and you could check that out. And in each pack they're different cards. And usually if I get the same cards I don't always show it. And the first card is really nice. And the first card they put is always like the rare holo. So I'm gonna put that to the back for now. We have a really cool Pikachu card, and even though it's not an EX, it's pretty cool, so I'll put it here. A Ho-Oh EX, some common cards, and this card is kind of nice, but the colors should have been a bit brighter in my opinion. And then the rare holo card is a Lugia. And I don't really like this holo that much, but I like that it looks kind of real, especially from the back, because some fake cards, like their cutting outs on the sides are like so off that it's so bad. So these are just our common cards, so I'll just put them over here. Next up we have Volcanion. They're gonna fall. Jirachi EX, and this is a really nice card because the colors are pretty good. another cool Pikachu card. And in all my opening videos, I never got the Pikachu card twice, except for the one where I opened most of the booster packs. And then a Mega Ampharos EX holo. And this is really cool. And the colors aren't bad, and it looks pretty cool that it's holo. It's probably one of my favorite cards in this whole set. And so far, in all the ones I opened like most of the booster box so far. And I didn't really get that many Megas. I think I only got like two so far. So this is pretty rare for these fake packs. Imagine I get another one in this. That would be amazing. A Latios EX. And there's an Exernius too. So for the Latios, I don't really like the colors. And then the holo is a Deoxys. And this is a pretty cool Pokemon. And these keep on falling. So they're finally standing up now. And now it's time for our last pack. And this is Exernius. I might have forgotten to say the pack names. This is Volcanion and this is Iavital. Here is Exernius, and it's a golden version of Exernius. Diancie EX, and I don't like the colors in this one either. And then the holo is a Exernius EX. This is the first Exernius EX I got in this whole booster box. I didn't start my second one yet. So, this is pretty rare too. So, I got two rare cards. So, these were some pretty great packs. I got two rare cards. It's an Exernius EX that's a holo. And a Mega Ampharos EX. We also have a Deoxys and Lugia holo. A Ho-Oh EX, two Pikachu Full Art cards, a Jirachi EX, a Latios EX, and a Diancie EX. So the other cards I don't like that much, except for the Jirachi EX. But I really love these two. And they are really rare because in the whole booster box, I only got one each of these cards. And it's in this video. So that's pretty amazing. And anyways, if you want to see my other videos from the whole booster box, be sure to check them and check my Pokemon videos playlist. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below. Hi guys, today I have Pokemon TCG Evolutions packs. And I have a Raichu pack over here, and I also have two more packs, which I will open in a separate video. And I ordered these before, but the shipping came pretty late. A lot of people like the Evolutions, and they came pretty late to me. And I'm also doing an advent calendar right now, so I already have some videos ready because I'm opening Funko Dorbs, and I have the full set, so I'm gonna upload all, like, I think I have 8 of them. I'm gonna upload all of those videos first, and then I'll upload this. Anyways, here is the Evolutions pack. And it looks pretty cool. This is Raichu. And I'll open it up, and the person I got it from said that this is not unweighed. It is unweighed, which means it's not weighed. So I'm hoping we get something really cool in this, since I only have 3 packs, and I got these for like $5 each. So it would be pretty sad if I get no good pulls in it. So I just cut the code out. And this is a card trick, but I'm not sure. We have a Poliwag, a Sandshrew, a Voltorb, a Magnemite, a Caterpie, a Reverse Holo Magikarp, a Nidorino, a Trainer, Professor Oak's Hint, a Charmeleon, and a really cool Raichu card. So no EXs in this pack, but still we got two holos. We have this Magikarp holo over here. And then we have this Raichu holo, which looks pretty cool. And then we just have these regular cards over here. So I don't know if this was actually weighted. It wasn't supposed to be, but there aren't any like extremely cool or rare or secret rare cards in here. So let's hope that the next pack is different. And be sure to stay tuned for when I upload that video. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below. Hi guys, today I have a Pokemon TCG Evolutions Venusaur Booster Pack. And I already opened the Raichu pack over there, and I'm gonna open the Blastoise one in a future video. And if you didn't watch the Raichu video yet, I got these cards earlier, but they took a long time to ship. Because I guess a lot of people loved Evolutions and got some pretty good pulls. And I'm really hoping for some good pulls in these. And from the person I got it said that these are not weighted. So I'm hoping that that's true and I get good cards in here. So anyways, let's open this pack up. And it contains a code for a bonus pack online. And I have given codes in previous videos, so be sure to check those out. But in this video, I'm not going to give the code. So we have a Poliwag, a Nidoran, a Onix, a Growlithe, a Machop, a Reverse Holo Nidoran, a Zapdos, a Trainer Pokedex, Slowbro, Spirit Link, and a Nidorino. So I forgot to do the card trick, and anyway, these are the two rare cards that we get. A nice Zapdos holo and a Nidorino. However, we did not get any EXs yet, or any secret rares, so these cards might have been weighed. Anyway, stay tuned for the Blastoise video so I could tell you if I got a really cool card in that or not. And anyways, thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below. Hi guys, today I have the Pokemon TCG Evolutions Booster Pack, and this is Blastoise. And they also have Raichu and Venusaur in the back, so if you want to check those videos out, be sure to check the description, or just check my channel if I didn't update the description yet. And I got these before, but they took a long time to ship because a lot of people wanted these Evolutions packs. And I'm happy that they finally came, and they just came today, and I'm opening them today. And I'm really hoping to get some good cards in this because I got these like $5 each at least, or $6, I'm not sure. And if I get no good cards, then it would be like a real waste of money. And I recently opened two whole booster boxes of fake cards, so be sure to check that out. And even though they were fake, there were some pretty cool cards in there, so, yeah. We have Charmander, Ghastly, Growlithe, a Energy, a Staryu, a reverse Sandshrew, a Haunter, a secret rare, a Makuni's Dodo. That's pretty cool. A Metapod and a Farfetch'd. So anyways, that's pretty cool that we got a secret rare in this. And if you want to see more TCG Booster Box or pack openings, be sure to subscribe and leave a comment down below. Thanks for watching! Hi guys, today I have a Pokemon TCG Snorlax GX box. And before I start, I wanted to wish everyone a Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, and Happy Holidays. And I also have Pokemon Sun today, and I already started playing it yesterday, but I don't know how to record it on my 3DS. So after I figure out that out, I'll post a link in the description for Pokemon Sun gameplay videos. And this is a Snorlax GX box. Snorlax GX, let me just turn it around. A Sleeping Giant Awakened, Snorlax GX. It says that Snorlax is powerful even in its sleep and even more dangerous when it finally wakes up as a Pokemon GX. And this includes two never-before-seen foil promo cards featuring Snorlax and Snorlax GX, one foil oversized card, four booster packs, and a code card. And if you want code cards, I already gave them away in previous videos. I might give it away in this video as well. So let me just cut the tape off. So I just got that open. So let me just take the plastic off. And I didn't open a Pokemon TCG box for a long time. Like, I think the last one I opened was a Mega Rayquaza, and I had a special guest open it for me. So this is our Snorlax GX card, and it looks really cool, and another Snorlax card. I'll show it up close again. We have two Blastoise packs. It would have been better if they gave two different packs, like Blastoise and Charizard. And I already opened some evolution packs on my channel, and you can check those videos out after. And today, I will give a free code card for the Snorlax GX box. And then we have this jumbo oversized card. Here is our oversized card. Snorlax GX. You could use move Collapse, but it makes the Pokemon sleep. But you could use Thunderous Snore when the Pokemon is asleep. And the GX move is 210. But you can't use more than one GX attack in a game. And I also have a Regigigas oversized card, a Charizard oversized card, and a Mega Rayquaza EX oversized card. And here's a small version of the Snorlax GX card. And then this is like an evolutions version of the Snorlax card. And if you notice on the bottom over here, it's X and Y, and this is Sun and Moon. I thought that this card was also supposed to be for Sun and Moon, but I guess not. So now let's open this breakthrough pack and hope for something good. And I realized that usually whenever you get a Pokemon box, you get at least one good card, like an EX. So there's a code card. We have Skyla, Spoopa, a Snorlax. I'm just putting that to the side since this is a Snorlax box. Cyndaquil, Hippopotas, Cubone, Elgium, Pansage, a Hollowed Typhlosion, and a Simisage. So now let's open a Fates Collide pack. And even though these cards are pretty cool, I would like an EX from the Evolutions pack, and the one I want the most is the Mega Charizard one, or the regular Charizard one. And if you didn't see my other videos, I do have a Mega Charizard EX, but that's a fake version. But those are pretty rare as well. But I would like the real version. So we have Shuckle, Fairy Garden, a Fossil Excavation Kit, a Snubbull, a Binnacle, a Meowth, a Jigglypuff, Ryolu, a really cool Reuniclus Holo, and a Lucario. So now let's open our next Blastoise X and Y Evolutions pack. Of Blastoise. We have a Trainer Potion, a Magmar, a Venusaur Spirit Link, a Pikachu, a Dodo, a Caterpie, a Drowsy, a Diglett, a Machamp, and a Chansey. And these are really cool cards. So it's time for our last pack, and this is the one that's supposed to have an EX in it, if I am right. I almost cut the cards open. In one video, actually, it wasn't Pokemon, but it was something like, I think it was a blind bag, and it cut one of the cards open, which was kind of funny. So we have a Magmar, a Energy Retrieval, a Blastoise Spirit Link, a Machop, a Weedle, a Onix, a Staryu, a Pikachu, and then we have a Haunter. And the reverse holo is a Raichu, which is pretty cool. So I got some pretty cool reverse holo cards, but I did not get an EX. We have a Reuniclus, or Reuniclus, holo with a cool pattern here, a Typhlosion, a Haunter, a Machamp, this really cool Raichu, and a Chansey. But we did not get an EX. And I really like these holo cards too, but I like EXs the best. And in the last, like, 8 packs of Pokemon cards that I opened, I didn't get any EXs. But I'll try to get some more Pokemon packs, and hopefully we could get an EX. And I have Pokemon Sun here, and stay tuned for gameplay for that, if I figure out how to record on the 3DS. And anyways, thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment below. Hi guys, I have the Minions Vinyl Figure Mystery Minis box, blind box from Funko. So these are the figures, and I'll take the plastic off first, and then I'll just show them. So there's a 1 in 12 chance of each, and they all look pretty cool. Like, but I probably want like King Bob or Stuart over here the most. I can't tell, is that Bob or Stuart? Wait, no, it's not Stuart because he has two eyes. Stuart has one eye and he has two eyes. It could be Kevin, but I feel like that's probably Bob. Not really sure. Comment down below and tell me what you think. Well, if I get the figure, then I'll be able to tell. So I can't really tell who it is, but I don't think it's Kevin because it feels kind of short. But there's not a big difference, so I could be wrong. It is Kevin. And this is a pretty cool figure. I didn't even notice this one. It was the first one, and he has his lava gun. That looks really nice. I think I'm gonna get some more Minions blind boxes because they look pretty cool. This looks amazing. I would have liked if in the lava lamp they could have added a little yellow to make it look better, but otherwise it's pretty cool. And anyway, thanks for watching and comment down below if you want me to get more Funko Mystery Minis and I'll try my best to get them. Thanks for watching, please like, subscribe, and comment below. Hi guys, today I have the Disney Heroes vs. Villains blind box from Funko. And I'll just get this off and then I'll show the box. So you don't really need a scissor. There we go. So we could see some of the Disney heroes and villains over here. Some more over here and over here. Like Anna and Marshmallow and Ariel and Ursula. And then Stitch over there. And for these figures, there's only a 1 in 12 chance. So all of these are pretty common. And you have an equal chance of getting any of these. And this box feels kind of heavy. And I'm hoping it is Marshmallow because it feels like him because this box feels heavy. But it could also be him. And I don't really remember his name, but I know that he's Stitch. I don't remember his name, so comment down below if you know. And then the other figures are pretty cool too. But since it's heavy, I'm gonna guess it's Marshmallow, which is a pretty cool figure. And usually the glue is not like this, which is kind of odd. And I got this from GameStop, and recently I got an Alice in Wonderland figure from GameStop too, and that also had like some weird packaging. Like there was no seal on it or anything. See, this is a pretty big figure. So let me try to guess who it is. So I feel like it is Marshmallow, but I don't really feel the spikes. So it might not be Marshmallow. I don't feel the spikes. So my best guess is that it is this person from Stitch, if it's not Marshmallow. Anyways, let's see who it is. It's none of them. It's Ursula. And this is a really nice figure. It didn't look too cool in the picture, but it is pretty cool. And my guess was completely wrong. Well, at least I guessed that it was a villain. She didn't look that big in the picture. Like, she didn't look as big as Marshmallow or this guy. But she is pretty big, so I guess my guess was wrong. And usually I guess right, if you saw some of my other Funko Mystery Mini videos. Like, I remember in the TMNT one, I was right. And I also got the Chaser in one of those videos, so be sure to check out my Blind Box Videos playlist to see more Funko Mystery Mini Blind Box videos. And anyway, here is Ursula. I'll show her up close. You could see the detail. It's so amazing. And when you look at it over here, it kind of looks like clay or Play-Doh, but it is a vinyl figure, And this is just the bottom. If you get Disney Vinylmations, then on the bottom, they, like, usually say the name. Like, I had one Vinylmation. It was the rare Star Wars Obi-Wan Chaser Ghost or something. And you can check that video out, too. And anyways, this is Ursula, and she's pretty cool. Anyways, thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment down below. Hi guys, today I have a Funko Disney Alistair the Looking Glass Vinyl Figure Mystery Mini. And I got this from GameStop. And if you know GameStop, you could probably tell this. However, there's no like seal on top of the box, because usually there is. Like for example, I also have this Minions one over here, and you could see that seal of plastic on it. And this one doesn't. And the glue over here is like really sticky, and that's not common. I'll try to focus. There we go. So I feel like someone might have like opened it and returned it or something, and then GameStop gave it to me. But I'm not sure, so I'll check that out. Anyways, these are all the figures that you could get, and this looks like a pretty cool set. And if I get a cool figure, I will get more of these. My favorite Mystery Mini so far was the Harry Potter one. And I was gonna get more, but I just decided to get different types of Mystery Minis to see or to find my favorite set. So anyway, these are the figures, and they look pretty cool, like, especially this rabbit looks cool. But I would probably want, like, the chaser the most, because he looks really cool. Or the rabbit looks pretty cool, too, even though it's pretty common. The most common is this cat, and that would be pretty sad to get, because it's a small figure. And this doesn't feel that heavy. So I'm hoping it's not like the cat or something, or like the mouse, or even Humpty Dumpty. Like, they're okay, but like the other figures look a lot cooler. Like, basically all the humans look pretty cool, and this one looks pretty cool too. But I would like the chaser or the rabbit the best, the most. And this is definitely not new. Well, the pack is sealed. It feels like someone really small. I think I might have gotten the cat or the mouse. Hopefully not. Yep, it's the cat. And this is 1 out of 6. I'll show it up close as well. So I feel like GameStop gave us an open box, because you could tell there was no plastic seal on it, the glue was weird, and the box was ripped, and the figure we got is 1 out of 6, the most common figure you could get. And that is possible to get a common figure. However, there are like so many other figures. And because of all this like damage on the box, I feel like GameStop might have given us an open box. Possibly that someone returned or something. So, I don't know. Comment down below and tell me what you think.